Why dimensional models are denormalized? Well, they don't have to be. But it is a very good question, and one that often comes in many dimensional model related discourses. It is true that some of the dimensional models do have some degree of denormalization built into it. Why? Let's find out. I will explain why dimensional models are denormalized with a practical example. Suppose you have a data warehouse which takes data from some kind of transaction processing system. So we have a OLTP system and we have a OLAP system, or you are using a dimensional modeling technique in your OLAP database. Now in your OLTP system, imagine that you have two different tables. You have a product table and you have a product type table. The product table contains the details of all the products. So for example, you are selling some goods and maybe it's an electronics shop and you are selling mobiles and camera, different types of mobiles and cameras, etc. And all those products are listed in your product tables. Whereas in the product type table, you have some kind of higher classification of these products. So maybe you have a type called mobile, or maybe you have a type called camera, right? And under this mobile, there are obviously many different types of many different brands of mobile that you sell. Similarly, there are many different brands of camera that you sell over here. So these are the two tables that you have in your OLTP system. And in the OLTP database, these two tables are obviously connected, right? So the product type key will flow into the product table as a foreign key, right? Now, if you take this example and try to build a OLAP system, you have basically two choices. If you wanted, you could create two different dimension tables for the product and the product type tables. On the other hand, you could also design your OLAP system as a star schema where you can combine the product and product type table together and sort of create a single dimension table in your OLAP system, right? So for example, in your OLAP system, you might have a product dimension table, and in this product dimension table, you will have the product ID, you will have the product name, as well as you will also have the type, right? So instead of keeping the type in a separate table as you have done in the OLTP system for the normalization requirements, in the OLAP database where you are using the dimensional schema, you could actually put both these two information together into a single product dimension table. The benefit of putting the information from these two tables together into a single product dimension table is whenever a user wants to query your database, this user doesn't need to query the information from two different tables. Imagine there is a user who wants to find out the type wise sales amount for each product, right? So for example, this user wants to find out how many total camera was sold. Let's say there are 200 different cameras have been sold, and there are 500 different mobile phones have been sold, right? So in order to find this information, obviously the user will have to query the star schema that you have created in your dimensional model. And presumably that star schema will have a look like this, where the fact table will be let's say the sales fact table will be in the center of the star schema, and we'll have a product table. We'll have our product table here, and we'll have our other dimension tables over around the fact tables as well. Right, so maybe this is our customer dimension table, this might be our time dimension table, or things like that. Now in this kind of construct, when the user wants to find out this information, the user will write queries, and those queries will hit the fact table, and then fact table will get joined with the product table to find out the product related information. In this case, information like the product type. As you can see from this picture, since both the product type and the product ID are in the same table, you can actually query this information from a single table itself. On the other hand, if you put this information into two different tables, such as you have a product table and you also have a product type table, then to find the same information that we have over here, you'll have to query both the product and product type table. That is one more additional join that you need to perform. Each time you want to find this information, you'll have to perform this additional join. However, by putting all this information in a single table, we can avoid doing these joins when we query this data from the schema. What do we lose? Well, we lose the degree of normalization. In the OLTP system, where the normalization really matters, we actually have these two tables separately maintained. However, in the OLAP system, where our main goal is to make data retrieval faster, we do not need to put these two information into separate tables, and we do not need to maintain the schema in the same high degree of normalization that we had in the OLTP system. The goal of the dimensional model is to make data reading faster, and that's why we try to make as less joins as possible. Now, I should also mention that there are some cases where deliberate normalization is also required in a dimensional model, and we will talk about those cases later on. But in general, always remember that the dimensional model is created to make data retrieval faster, and that's the reason dimensional models are often denormalized.